So once again, good evening. So dahil naka-Zoom ako, yung presentation ko ina-Zoom, kaya medyo bilisan ko. It's also in YouTube kasi meron siyang time limit ng video. So kailangan kong bibilisan. So my discussion for this evening is all about implementing the curriculum, the teacher as the curriculum implementer and the manager. Actually, it's very easy to understand. And obviously, the teacher are the curriculum implementer and the manager, nobody else, diba? But before that, let's discuss first our objective. First objective is we were going to define curriculum implementation. Also, you were going to analyze what is change in process or change process in curriculum implementation. Also, we will go try to explain the process of curriculum implementation, review the components of a daily plan for teaching, meron ganon, as actually I included that in your activity. Also, we were going to identify intended learning outcomes and match learning outcomes with appropriate teaching method. Okay, so let's start with our lesson with the teachers as curriculum developers and implementers. So obviously, since the teacher are the one making the curriculum, I mean preparing, also, we are the one developing and implementing the curriculum. So teaching and learning process, the other side of the coin is the teacher. Yes, so when we say teaching and learning process, it talks about the teacher. So planning and writing the curriculum are the primary roles of the teacher. Siyempre, if you are the teacher, you are going to plan on what you are going to teach for the day, what lesson. And aside from that, if you plan, you also write or in a form of writing, you were going to write your curriculum or your lesson. So a teacher is a curriculum maker, and that's correct. He or she writes curriculum daily through a lesson plan, unit plan, or yearly plan. Excuse me. So this time of pandemic, actually, walang lesson plan si teacher, no? But anong ginagawa natin? We have the weekly learning or weekly learner home plan, meaning the students are guided with the modules, the activities in the modules, and the teacher will going to prepare on what to do or what activities should the students answer for this day. Kaya ito lang, no? My advice is for the students, we should enjoy answering the modules. Na? The module is intended for the students, not for auntie, not for tita, not for the guardian. So yung mga module, it should be answered by the students. And for the students, for the pupils, enjoy lang pag-answer. Kasi personally, when I studying in MSU, talagang it come with my mind na mag-stop, maging depressed, pressure with academic requirements, but still, all we need to do is to have faith in God. We can answer those problems, the modules, with the help of our God. Mag-pray lang, kayang-kaya yan. No? Ginawa ng mga teacher yung module, para di ma-answeran ng mga estudyante. Also, the teachers prepare activities for the students to do. Since this pandemic time, no, yung mga activities planned by the teacher actually integrate namin yung nasa module. And nung gumawa si teacher ng mga module, okay, i-discuss natin sa current event ngayon, yung paggawa namin ng module actually, lahat yun plinano to make you very safe na hindi na kailan lumabas pa ng bahay. Kahit nasa loob lang ng bahay, you can answer or you can do the activities in the module. Now, let's continue. So the teachers as curriculum developers and implementers, that's it. So the teacher addresses the goals, the needs, interests of the learners by creating experiences from where the students can learn. So malaki talaga ang role ni teacher in preparing, planning, implementing the curriculum. So actually the teacher also designs, no, enriches and modifies the curriculum to suit the learner's characteristics. Again, for example, if this teaching strategy is not applicable for the learner, then the teacher will go to change or improve. No? So as teacher, as a curriculum developer, teachers are part of the textbook committees. Yes, as I said, faculty selection board, school evaluation committee, or textbook writer themselves. So as teachers, again, we are the textbook committee. Right? Nag-evaluate ng module, textbook, or even writers of our modules and textbook. So my big salute to all the teachers who are part of preparing the modules for our learners, no? Grabe, dugo, buhis, buhay na paggawa ng mga modules. And then here comes may mga students na nagpo-post lang na ano ba yan, maraming answer sa modules. Actually, dumaan sa maraming series of evaluation yung mga modules na ginawa. So for views of the students about the teacher as a curriculum maker and implementer, here it is. Teachers are the most crucial persons in the implementation of a curriculum. Please take note, and that's true. Teachers shape the school curriculum by sharing the experiences that they have and the resources they are capable of giving or imparting to the learners. So as teachers, again, we are the crucial person on the implementation of our curriculum. So therefore, no technology can ever replace a teacher. It will only support the multifaceted role of the teacher. Actually, we need technology, but take note, technology cannot replace us as a teacher, right? Thus, the complexity of teaching requires tremendous maturity, decision-making, and the implementation of any curricular plan as a choice of materials, methods, or strategies of teaching and modes of evaluation. So actually, before, no, I graduated from my struggles as a teacher, no, parang it molded me how many years to become not so good, but yung tama-tama lang, or the correct term is mature talaga, no, requires tremendous maturity. So what else? So also, teachers are the curriculum managers and administrators. In a school organization, there is always a curriculum manager, and that's true, or school administrator. In fact, for school principals, one of their functions is being the curriculum manager. So even we are the implementer, but we have our principal to check or manage our curriculum. So why are school administrators and curriculum managers important to curriculum implementation? Why we need them? Why we need the school principal in our curriculum? It's because the school administrators play an important role in shaping the school curriculum because, so this is the answer, they are the people who are responsible in the formulations of the school's vision, philosophy, missions, and objectives. So they provide necessary leadership in evaluating teaching personnel and school programs. Also, they are keeping records of the curriculum and reporting learning outcomes are also the manager's responsibilities. Okay, again, when you become a school administrator, parang marami ka ng trabaho. No? They are the one keeping the records of curriculum and reporting learning outcomes. So from time to time, actually, they, for example, this time, they are very busy finalizing the numbers of enrollees, the teaching personnel, plus program, napakarami nilang pinaproblema. But when you become a school administrator, actually, you should know, or you should, when before you are going to accept the job, I think your mind should be ready. So in addition, the school administrators have the responsibility of running the school effectively. So my salute to all our school administrators because they play an important role and every day they encounter stress, but they are matured enough to handle the situation. A school administrator have to oversee the smooth transition of the child from one grade level to another, and they should see to it that the curriculum is implemented vertically or horizontally with very minimal overlaps. So instead, there should be continuity, relevance, balance, so that the curriculum will produce a well-rounded person. So that's it. yun ang role talaga ng school administrator. So indeed, the role of the administrator can never be ignored. Yes, they are very important. The principle of command, responsibility, and institutional leadership rest on the shoulder of the school administrator. So actually, my big salute to all the school administrators. Why? Because they are the one inspiring us to do the job and protecting us and giving us feedbacks on how to become effective planner and implementer of the curriculum. So that's all for this night. Thank you for watching. I hope that your time was not wasted with our lesson. So again, I'm willing to accept your ano na, yung mga shout out, but mag-goodbye muna ako doon sa isa kong presentation. Thank you so much for listening. God bless everyone.